The role of setting the maximum lending rates for banks is set to be taken away from the Central Bank of Kenya should the Treasury's proposal to repeal again its Section 33B of the Banking Act sails through. According to Cabinet Secretary for Treasury Henry Rotich, access to credit by the private sector and SMEs has been hampered by the cap interest rates.
Given the challenges that the micro, small and medium enterprises are facing in accessing credit from the banking sector, and cautious of the need to spur business activity, I am in this year's finance bill proposing a repeal of Section 33B of the Banking Act 2016. I'm convinced this will unlock credit to the private sector and in particular to the SMEs.
The CSA, the country needed to raise revenue up to the tune of 2.1 trillion shillings to finance the budget, and in doing so, he slapped 15% excise duty on alcoholic beverages and tobacco products.
With the increasing demand to mobilize resources, there is need to expand the tax base and enhance our revenue. Over the years, with the expanded economy, there has been an increase in services that are offered on commercial basis, some of which are not within the ambit of withholding tax.
This, according to Rotich, is expected to help boost excise revenues.
Excise revenue has declined from approximately 3% of GDP in 2003-2004 to 2% in 2017-2018.
Gambling activities were also on the receiving end after the Cabinet Secretary proposed to introduce excise duty on betting activities at the rate of 10% of the amount staked.
Betting has become widespread in our society, and its expansion has had negative social effects, particularly to the young and vulnerable members of our society. In order to curtail the negative effect arising from betting activities, I propose to introduce excise duty on betting activities at 10% at the amount staked.
Those in the border and tuk-tuk transport service were also not spared after Rotich introduced new insurance proposals aimed at covering the riders, passengers and even pedestrians. Brian Itava, Channel One Business.